sir. Honorable members will recall that the bill was introduced in the House of the People on the 2nd September 2003. It has had a long history and in one form or another it has been before the public since the end of 1949. In the statement of objects and reasons, the various stages through which the bill has passed since 1946 have been summarized, and I need not recapitulate on this occasion the circumstances in which the then Government of India took the decision in early 1946 to initiate an inquiry into the reform of our company law. I would remind honorable members that between 1946 and 1948, the entire field of company law was carefully reviewed by two distinguished company lawyers who were appointed to recommend the broad lines on which the present act should be revised. Their recommendation were examined in the then Ministry of Commerce and certain tentative departmental views which emerged were circulated in a comprehensive memorandum to all recognized trade and industrial associations, bar associations, the high courts and the state governments. That brought us to the end of 1949. Many representations on this memorandum were duly received from chambers of commerce, trade and industrial associations, state governments and the general public at the end of 2000. The Government of India appointed a committee under the chairmanship of Shri Bhabha to go into the entire question of the revision of the Companies Act with particular reference to its bearing on the development of trade and industry in this country. This committee examined a large number of witnesses in many parts of the country and submitted its report. In March 2002, this report again was circulated to all state governments, chambers of commerce